Hi guys, I'm Matt from NI, and I'm one of our business development managers in the transportation business unit. I look after our hub-in-the-loop testing business. I'm here today with Chris from Aliaro, and we're going to give you an overview of the XMove platform. So Chris, first up, can you give us an overview of what the XMove platform actually is?
Okay, so what we have in front of us here today is a half rack test system that's been customized for our automotive customers. It has all the standard components that you would expect from a test system, including panel controls, PDU and power supply, and then we also have our XMove test boxes. These test boxes can be reconfigured as needed by the DUT or the type of test that's being done. Usually our customers, they configure a particular XMove box for a certain kind of test or for a certain kind of DUT. For example, this XMove box may be configured and handling, for example, battery management simulation. And then the one next to you, Matt, at the moment might be handling, for example, powertrain testing.
Okay, great. So these boxes are typically associated with a ECU under test, it sounds like. How are they typically built up and configured?
So here at Aliaro, we're about white box solutions. We have, for example, configurations on the rack level, having multiple racks in the slave master configurations. And then we have configurations at the box level as well. So at the box level, it uses modular NI internal components, such as SLSE boards, to allow for easy upgrades, easy switching. The boxes themselves can be removed very quickly and easily and replaced and upgraded. We can move boxes between different rack systems, as the rack is always the same, regardless of the type of test system that we're doing, which means that our systems are able to use this kind of like Lego for HIL design, where they're able to slot boxes in and out as and when needed.
Okay, so that enables guys in the audience to actually be able to reconfigure their test system based off the changing test requirements that may happen as part of a full development program. How do they actually configure the connection when they've got an ECU they want to bring in, actually interface to this test system?
Yes, so as I mentioned before, we have our configurations for our rack and our box level, and we can also configure the system on the pin level as well. So if take, for example, our standard industry icon connector we have on the front of our test system. This corresponds with our device under test, in this case a toy car. The harness here, we can see a series of pins on the inside of this connector, and that maps identically to the graphical representation of an icon connector in our test software. So this is XMove Configurator. This is what we use to configure all of our test systems. If we select one of our pins, for example, the first pin on the top left of our system, we have various different kinds of functions that we can apply to that pin. The functions that we have available for that pin vary depending on the internals of the box, but we have functionality for multifunction I/O, for bus switching, for resistor emulation, and for battery management simulation. You can see we can choose an item from that list. We can also see all of the current configurations we have on that pin. This particular pin, for example, is currently configured for an analog input.
So I've got my DUT. I need to configure a specific pin for my wiring harness. How do I actually apply the properties of that channel to that signal path?
Yes, so what we would do is we would select the pin we want to modify. We would right-click on it and we would add a function. Then we can see the list of functions we have available for that pin. We would select, for example, analog output function. We would then select a function value. The function value will vary depending on the type of function you're applying to the pin. In this case, the function value is the scale of the output. For an analog input, it might be, for example, how we are scaling down the signal that's coming in. Let's set that function value to 3, so it will be scaled up by 3 times the voltage. We press OK, and then our current configuration updates with the analog output.
Okay, so that scaling is happening in a hardware level. So we're actually applying amplification or attenuation to a signal rather than just scaling it in software.
Yes, that's correct. It's being applied on the actual board itself, but it's being configured entirely from a software environment.
Okay, so I'm a tester, a hardware engineer. I've configured my tester. I've plugged in my ECU under test. And now I actually want to be able to configure a test system. How do I do that?
Yes, so we're on to the final stage of our configuration process. We've added everything we need onto our pins. We would go back to the File tab. What we could then do is we could save our configuration and share it with our colleagues and our friends, use it between multiple different systems. As I mentioned before, the rack is the same in every kind of system that we're using. We could also export the system configuration directly from XMove Configurator. This would export a system definition file that we could load up inside of Veristand, such as the one that we have on the left screen here. Inside of that, XMove Configurator will create a series of aliases. Those alias names will correspond with the names inside of XMove Configurator, and then customers, users can directly interact with those aliases. And when we make changes to the configuration in XMove, it automatically updates inside of Veristand without the user having to do anything in Veristand at all.
Okay, so the HIL engineer in Veristand doesn't actually need to be aware of the harnessing or the signal path connecting the device and the test to the actual test infrastructure. They just need to be aware of the functionality on the DUT, and then they can operate an interface directly.
Exactly, that's correct. And everything is done, again, from the perspective of the icon connector. So it's stored in an icon folder, and it gives a unifying language to all the engineers and the operators that are working on the system.
Okay, so something I know the guys in the audience will be asking about is, we've talked about HIL and how this works, but we haven't mentioned fault insertion. How does that work in the system?
Yes, that is a big concern for our customers as well. Fault insertion comes native to all of our pins in our system. It's on all of the boards that we produce. The specific kind of fault insertion that's available will vary depending on the type of functionality, but you might have all the ones that you would expect, like open circuit, short circuit, outputting an auxiliary signal from a power supply or other source.
Okay, great. And once a customer's kind of built the system, configured it, used it, the first customers who started using this, what was their response to this type of system?
I think initially they were quite surprised over the control and the flexibility they have over systems like ours. I think they're also extremely pleased with the functionality, how they're able to quickly configure things only in software without having to worry about rewiring or reconfiguring systems manually. They're also extremely pleased with how it could export to Veristand, and they wouldn't need to directly make any changes there without coming out of the XMove Configurator software.
Okay, great. Thank you very much, Chris. Hopefully this has been useful and you've been able to kind of get an overview of the platform and some of the benefits and features. I think you can see it's a very flexible platform, both in a hardware and software point of view. If you want to know more, please reach out to your sales representative or follow the link at the end of this video for more information.